Good morning. Whew, it's gonna be hot today. My dad used to say on these summer mornings, it's gonna be a scorcher. So some weathercasters have the temperature up at 104 and some at 108. So we're gonna be inside most of the day, but I'm out here in a little bit of the cool of the morning because I wanna give my plants some extra water because of the very high temperatures. I'm hoping that it doesn't burn a lot of my veg. So I'm worried about that. But I just thought I would do an early morning garden wander with you. There's some interesting things happening and things I'm keeping my eye on. So let's take a look. My newly planted tower garden is doing well. The plants are not growing exponentially, but they're growing, they're fine. They used to be little slips of things. You can see I've got some flowers, some little violas, darling. Also, marigolds are coming. Parsley, don't remember what that is. But anyways, things are coming, and I've already had a couple strawberries that I've eaten. Here's one, here's a little strawberry coming. You might notice if you've been watching that I took down one of my hollyhocks. I'll show you where I put the stems because I am planning on harvesting the seeds again. It was a big job, but it was a fun job, so I'll do that. Over here in the veg garden, we've got tomato mania going on. Almost all the bushes have an abundance of tomatoes. Except one, I'll say. This is the Austin pear, which has a lot of tomatoes. Again, this is the one that was hit the hardest by the disease, the tomato disease. So it doesn't have a lot of green on it. I'm not sure how many more tomatoes, but we'll let it keep going. It's an indeterminate plant. This one is the chica cherry, doing really well. Did not have the disease as badly. This is the one tomato that's not doing so well. Why watch it every day? This is called the Smurf, Dancing with Smurfs plant. So I've had one of the tomatoes off of it. It's very good, but it's very small, but still growing, still good. This little guy's going crazy, but look at how tiny, tiny, tiny the tomatoes are. Really tiny. I'll pop that one in. Mm-hmm. Yum. That's called Sweetheart of the Patio. Then over here, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna be pulling up these onions. Look at them. This one's almost all the way out of the ground. So he's happy. Then I've got these bells. Now these bells were looking great until about a day ago. And now look, some burn. These are the mini bells. Also doing quite well. I'm gonna pull off those orange ones today. Here's another happy tomato. This is called Orange Parouche. Look, 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 look. Eggplant, eggplant. Pretty happy. Although I have to say the eggplants are, you know, very heavy and the plant itself is not very sturdy. So I put up little stakes on it. So hopefully it'll grow. I have not really harvested much of the kale because I'm going to let it bolt. I think it's going to be beautiful. And so I want to just let it grow. This I thought was a miniature, you know, a cherry tomato. It's the 2021 tomato of the year. It's called Lava Flow. Or maybe it's the 2020. It's called Lava Flow tomato of the year. And it's going to be a big tomato. I'm surprised I don't have any of those in my garden, so I'm happy about that. This is my very favorite Sun Gold. I ate several of those every day. So that's the veg garden. Over here, the corn, you know, this corn, not really very straight, is it? But it's gonna grow one little ear, and here's another little ear on this one. The delphiniums here are bloomed out, but they were beautiful.
There's a cherry. Look at this cherry. Do you see how tall this is? It's huge. It's the only cherry. No, it's not true. It's one of two tomatoes that I put in the ground, and it went. It's crazy, going crazy. The butterfly bush is so happy this year. Both of them. I like them because of the height. Once I take down the hollyhocks, I won't have a lot of height in the garden, and they will provide that. So that's nice. My artichoke is kind of spindly this year. I don't know what's going on there. My dill died. It was right here. That makes me sad. This is the second year that my dill has died. I don't know what's going on there. It's agapanthus season. Agapanthus. Love those little purple blooms. Yep. They're very beautiful. And over here, this beautiful rose. Just all season long. So much color. The Gerbera daisy's doing well. More corn. My Barbra Streisand rose just bloomed again for the second time. The delphiniums are still showing off. And here it is in this incredible heat. I'm very proud of them. And look, my poppies are still going. So, I feel happy that despite this onslaught of heat, that things are doing well. My sunflowers, some of them are still blooming. Some of them are, you know, on their way out, but this one is lovely and blooming. And let me show you over here. I think we might be able to find, there we go. Do you see? I have a boysenberry. And here's a couple things that I did that I'm gonna do separate videos of. I pulled out the nasturtiums, but I'm going to harvest the seeds, and I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna do that. But for the moment, they're just just lying there on the island. And one more thing. Here's the spent hollyhock stems that I just took down. And so I'm going to harvest those seeds and show you how I will do that very soon. Whew, wish us luck in this heat. P.S. Cukes. I know you don't believe me, but it is 108 degrees. Oh my gosh, I'm so worried about my plant. What is happening? All right, this is not possible. This is a craziness.